Hello. In this video, we will be going over some basic configurations of a pool, volume, and LEN mapping using a JetStor 826 IXD. We will then be connecting directly to our ESXi 6.5 host to set up the networking and connect the volume that we created. First, we'll need to log into the 826 IXD. The default username and password is admin and 8 zeros. Once logged in, to get started, under the host connectivity section, click on iSCSI ports. Here, we will see all of the ports available to us in our system. We'll start off by configuring controller 1 port 1 with its new IP address. Move on to controller 2 to set its IP address. Once this is set, click on iSCSI targets. Find the first target of ID 0. Click on the drop-down arrow and click Change Network Portal. Here, you will see any ports available on the system that you would like to advertise on. Do the same for controller 2. Once these settings are set, we'll move on to create a pool. Under Storage Management, click on Pools. Click Create Pool. Select the type of provisioning. Enter a name and a preferred controller. Click Next. Now you will see all available disks to you for the pool. Select any that you would like. Click Next. Select the RAID level that you would like to use. Any additional disk properties. And click Finish. After that, under the same storage management section, click on Volumes. Click Create Volume. Enter the volume name that you would like. The pool that it will reside on. The size. Click Next. Select any other additional properties. And click Finish. The disk will erase for a period of time. The more space, the longer this will take. While this is going on, we'll head to LUN Mappings under the Storage Management section. And we'll click Map LUN. Here, we will see any of the volumes that we've created available to us. In this, you can add individual IQNs for the hosts if you would like to restrict access. In this case, we're going to just be using all hosts. The same target that we found in the previous section, and whichever LUN ID we would prefer. Once this is finished, we've completed the basic settings on the JetStor unit, and we'll need to log into our VMware host to complete the rest. Once logged in, we'll click on the Configuration tab, double check our iSCSI settings under the network. Since we do not have any in here, we will go ahead and add that networking now. Click on Add Networking, then VM Kernel. Click Next. Select the VM NIC that you would prefer. Click Next. Give your network a label. Click Next. Assign an IP address. click Next, and Finish. Repeat this for any additional iSCSI ports that you will have on your system. Once this is finished, we'll need to head over to the storage adapters section. And in this case, we do not have a iSCSI adapter available. We'll click on Add, add an iSCSI adapter. After a short period of time, when the adapter appears, select it, click on Properties, click on the Network Configuration tab, and then click on Add. Here we should see various port groups available to us. We'll select the ones that we set up for our iSCSI. Once they are available, we'll head over to the Dynamic Discovery tab and add the IP addresses for our JetStore Controller 1 and Controller 2 IP addresses. Once both controllers are added in, we'll go ahead and click on Close and click Yes to rescan the adapter. After a short period of time, whenever this completes, you should hopefully see your volume appear in the devices list. There we have our volume that we created. We can right click on this to manage paths, select the appropriate path selection that you would like, hit change, click close. We'll head over to the storage section to actually format our volume. We can click on add storage, disk or LUN. Here we see our same JetStore volume, click on Next, Next, enter a name. And click Finish. Once this is done, we now have our iSCSI volume available for use. There you have it. There's some basic configurations of your JetStore 826 IXD and a VMware ESXi 6.5 host.